in the face of climate change. We've lost 95% of Tasmania's giant kelp forests. When we lose those giant kelp forests, we lose the habitat and we lose crucial biodiversity. But unfortunately, for most people, these magnificent forests are out of sight and out of mind. One of my very first dives was in a giant kelp forest off Tasmania, and I still remember with real clarity descending down through the canopy and then looking back up through the water column at the shafts of light and that very golden colour. And that kelp forest doesn't exist anymore.
There is really only 5% left. There are remnant forests and a few scattered individuals around the place.
If we'd seen 95% of the Daintree rainforest disappear, there would be a very different response from the community.
We are looking at the genetic diversity of what's left and trying to understand that and breed that back into the forests.
Just keeping track of giant kelp populations is a mammoth challenge.
It's more than looking for a needle in a haystack. It's looking for a needle in a haystack that's been thrown in the ocean.
Looking at the incredible work done by CSIRO, IMAS and TNC, we could see how Google's AI tools can help.
The opportunity that Google has provided to map giant kelp at national scale is a complete game changer for us.
Working with our geospatial experts, we could help speed up the process of mapping and identifying those remaining giant kelp forests. Our AI tools can also help speed up genetic analysis and identify those genetic traits that make the kelp heat resistant.
Heat tolerance is really complicated. There's not one simple factor that will affect thermal tolerance in giant kelp.
We need AI to uncover the patterns in this huge amount of data. I mean, the human brain is good, but not that good.
I don't want to be in a position where I'm trying to describe to my grandchildren what marine habitats used to look like in Tasmania and elsewhere in the world. The current collaboration that we have, for the first time, is giving us real hope that we might be able to do something positive in a way that we simply could not have dreamed of if we had been working alone.
I think we can make really positive change. We're acting now to save the giant kelp.
It's going to have impact globally, not just within Australia. This is going to be really groundbreaking work.